Hold on, you were asking something.
Why this sudden spurt of hypothyroidism?
It can be seen in two ways, madam. One way is, probably the diagnostic is happening now. Rampant, everybody is doing a thyroid profile. So, initially it was in the, again, in the scope of only physician and endocrine people. Now everybody is doing a thyroid profile. Just like a routine fitness also. So diagnosis is coming up. So maybe it was there even before, now it is coming. Second is, can excess iodine intake be one of the reason? There is a probability, why not? The question mark is always there. Because when the iodine supplementation was started, it was mainly for the hilly areas and those places where the only source of iodine could be water. But now it is everywhere. And salt intake definitely has gone up. So I am very, very sure some iodine intake might have also gone up. And iodine induced hypothyroidism, we all know. Initial hyper and then hypo, we all know about it. Third is autoimmune.
Autoimmune.
So autoimmune is very, very important. And autoimmunity is again building up in the body, in the population. And for autoimmunity, the hygiene hypothesis. The hygiene hypothesis says that if you are keeping your children very clean and this, they are going to develop autoimmune problem later on in the life, which is a proven thing.
And stress also.
So and stress is the mainstay of everything. So stress is a base and everything is fitting on that. You got it? So hygiene hypothesis is also fitting in it. So young children are getting hypothyroidism. So first is diagnosis. So jo hidden the, wo dekh rahe hai humko. Second is the genetic pooling. Third, autoimmunity. Maybe whatever our lifestyle.
Not in males, it is in females that we see more.
Autoimmunity.
Autoimmunity.
Female autoimmunity.
Like if one sibling is having other.
Female autoimmunity and genetic linkage is definitely there. With both thyroid and diabetes.
Why females are more prone to autoimmunity?
Why females are
more prone to autoimmunity? Any hormonal.